We've just explored how quick isometrics function. Now, let's proceed with generating production isometric drawings to compare the two approaches and understand why both are essential in the design workflow. First, navigate to the 10_model file located in Chapter 10, Plant 3D Drawings. Simply double-click the file to open it. Previously, I manually selected elements and temporarily unloaded XRefs to visually confirm my selections. This time, however, we'll take a slightly different approach. When generating a production isometric, we assume that the pipeline is fully completed and ready for the final isometric to be processed for IFC, issued for construction. Unlike quick isometrics, production ISOs do not require XRefs to be unloaded, and selection is done using a different method. To begin, navigate to the ISO tab in the ribbon menu. Instead of selecting quick ISO, choose production ISO. You'll notice that the interface differs slightly from before. Since our pipeline is finalized, the system retrieves all line numbers from the project. When selecting a specific line number, the software generates an isometric drawing for all pipelines associated with that number. For this example, let's also adjust the ISO style. This time, I'll select Final ANSI C. You'll notice that, unlike the previous quick ISO process, we don't have the option to specify a custom save location. The designated folder for production isometrics is predefined by the project administrator during the initial project setup, ensuring consistency across the workflow. Now, let's proceed by selecting line number 200. I'll check the corresponding box and then navigate to the advanced file settings. If needed, a revision number can also be added at this stage. Moving to the advanced options, we now have additional functionalities beyond just exporting a bill of materials, BOM. Depending on how the isometric settings were configured, whether welds or cut pieces are displayed, the system allows exporting this data to CSV, Excel, or text files. Before finalizing, I'll modify the settings to increase congestion, reducing the number of individual drawings. Now, let's confirm the settings and click OK to generate the isometric. Once the isometric drawings are ready, you'll see the same dialog box as before. Clicking on the generated link reveals that a drawing has been successfully created. Unlike the quick isometric, which displayed a generic user-defined line number, this production ISO correctly assigns the line number 200, ensuring proper tracking. The system recognizes that the pipeline is fully processed and the files are named accordingly. Opening the generated isometric drawing, we can observe some key differences. The bill of materials, BOM, is now categorized by component type, pipes, fittings, fasteners, valves, and supports. Additionally, a cut piece list is included, along with a weld list in the bottom corner. These modifications reflect the structured nature of production isometrics designed for fabrication and construction use. It's important to note that while the overall process remains similar, the final ANSI C template has been configured to include more detailed project-specific data. The layout and content of these isometrics can be customized to align with client or project requirements, with the project administrator making the necessary adjustments. Next, let's explore the file structure. Navigate to the Exercise Files folder on the desktop, then go to Chapter 10, Isometric. Within the final ANSI C subfolder, you'll see both PCF files used for piping fabrication and the production isometric drawings. Unlike the Check ISO folder generated during quick isometric creation, these are stored under production ISOs, reinforcing their purpose in the final project documentation. Inside, you'll find 200 DWG from 1 to 4, the isometric drawings we just created. Now, let's examine a key distinction in Project Manager. Looking at the isometric drawings section, notice that when we previously ran a Check ANSI C isometric, no drawings appeared here. However, because we ran a final ANSI C isometric for line 200, it now displays a completed drawing under that line number. This provides a visual confirmation that the pipeline's design phase is finished and a production isometric has been generated. This feature allows you to easily track completed isometrics versus those still in progress. To reinforce this, let's generate additional production isometrics for different lines. Jumping back into the model, I'll select production ISO, and this time choose line numbers 300 and 400. Keeping the final ANSI C format, I'll go into advanced options, increase congestion to consolidate drawings, and proceed with the generation. This process runs in the background, and once completed, we'll revisit the project manager to observe how these newly generated isometrics integrate into the overall project workflow.